What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com. So I suppose that after watching the previous videos on instead of triggers, you have well understood that their main advantage is that by using them we can update the views which are non-updatable. Unfortunately, with Oracle database we are restricted to write such powerful triggers only on views and not on tables. Anyways, let's move ahead and see the third trigger in the series on instead of triggers in Oracle database and learn how to create an instead of delay trigger. Similar to other instead of triggers which we have seen so far, using this we can override the standard action of delete DML on a view. So let's proceed to create our own instead of delete trigger. For this demonstration, I will again use the view VW_RebellionRider which we created earlier and have consistently used in this instead of trigger series so far. Needless to say that executing delete DML on this view will return an error because of its non-updatable nature. Thus, the only way to perform delete DML on this view is by using an instead of trigger. Let's quickly create one. But before that, let's close this script output and clear the screen. That's great. Here is our trigger. First line starts with the keyword create followed by or replace optional clause. This clause will replace the already created trigger with the same name if you have any. Next, we have another keyword trigger, which lets your compiler know that we are creating a database object which is a trigger. Then in the second line, we have action event that is instead of delete. This call for action will make sure that this trigger will execute every time a delete DML fires on the underlying view, which is VW_RebellionRider, which we have specified next using keyword on. In third line, we have for each row clause, which will ensure that the trigger executes for every single row of the view. Finally, we have the body of the trigger. For the sake of better and clear understanding of the concept, we only have two delete DMLs which will do the work. So let's execute this instead of delete trigger and compile it. Trigger compiled successfully. Now let's test whether we can execute a delete DML on our view or not. Execute. All the rows where full name was Tony Stark are deleted, which means our trigger is working successfully. Hope you learned something and enjoyed watching. If so, then make sure to smash the thumbs up button. Also, help others in learning by sharing this video on your social media. I guess this will be the last tutorial in the series on triggers in Oracle database. Next week, we will start something new, so stay tuned. Check out this blog on my website for some helpful tips on LinkedIn profile building. Link is in the description. Also, in the previous video, I announced another giveaway, so make sure to participate. You can also follow me on my Twitter for more regular updates. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.